equations of uniformly accelerated motion by calculus method. Consider an object moving in a straight line with uniform or constant acceleration a. Let u be the initial velocity of the object at time t is equal to 0, v be the final velocity of the object at a particular time t, s be the displacement of the object at time t. So the first relation which we are going to derive is the velocity time relation. The acceleration of an object at any instant is given by the first derivative of velocity with respect to time. So we can write a is equal to dv by dt. And this can be written as dv is equal to a dt. Okay. Now, integrating on both the sides. When you integrate on both the sides, velocity changes from u to v, that is initial velocity to final velocity. Time changes from 0 to t, that is initial time is 0 and final time is t. So I am going to write it as integral dv is equal to, so velocity is changing from u to v is equal to integral a dt. Here time is the variable, so it changes from 0 to t. Now here a is a constant, so I can write it as, take it a outside and write it as 0 to t dt. Now what is integral dv? Integral dv is v. So here substituting the limits here, uv, and here it is a, integral dt is t, 0 to t. Okay. Now substituting the limits, this is upper limit minus lower limit. So first we are putting, going to put v instead of v only. So here it is v minus, for v we are going to write it as u is equal to a into, for t I am going to substitute t. Here from t I am going to substitute 0. So this is upper limit minus lower limit. So now this can be written as v minus u is equal to a into t. So we can write it as v is equal to u plus a t, which gives you the velocity time relation. So v is equal to u plus a t. Displacement time relation. The velocity of the body is given by the first derivative of the displacement with respect to time. So we can write velocity is equal to ds by dt. Velocity is rate of change of displacement. Now we can write ds is equal to v dt. Okay. Now I am going to substitute v is equal to u plus at. So ds is equal to u plus at into dt. So I can write ds is equal to u dt plus at dt. Okay. Now integrating on both the sides. Here, integral ds, displacement is varying from 0 to s, is equal to integral u dt. Here time is the variable, time varies from 0 to t, plus integral at dt. Here also time is the variable, so time varies from 0 to t. Okay. Now integral ds is s. Integral ds is s. So s, here the limits are 0 and s. Here u is a constant, so taking u outside, integral dt is t, so it is 0 to t. Here it is a. A is constant. It is integral t dt. Integral t dt is t square by 2. We are using the formula here. Integral t dt is equal to t square by 2. Okay. So, this is the formula we are using. So, substituting the limit, s minus 0 is equal to u into here t minus 0 plus a by 2 I am taking outside. For t square, I am putting it as t square minus 0. So, it is s is equal to ut plus a t square by 2. So, which can be written as s is equal to ut plus half a t square. Now, we got the displacement time relation. The next is velocity displacement relation. The acceleration is given by the first derivative of velocity with respect to time. So, we can write a is equal to dv by dt. Okay. Now, I am going to multiply and divide by ds. And I am going to rearrange it. So, I can write it as dv by ds into ds by dt. We know v is equal to ds by dt. So, we can write a is equal to, for ds by dt, I am going to write it as v. V into dv by ds. Okay. Now, this can be written as, okay. A into ds is equal to v dv. A into ds is equal to what? V dv. Now, integrating on both the sides. So, A integral A ds 0 t, as here s is the variable. This is equal to integral u to v v dv. Because velocity is the variable, velocity, initial velocity is u, final velocity is v. So, take A outside. A is a constant. So, integral 0 to s ds is equal to integral u to v v dv. So, integral s is what? Ds is s. 0 to s is equal to integral v dv, that is v square by 2. U and v. So, a into s minus 0. Substituting upper limit and lower limit. Here it is. Substituting upper limit v square by 2. Substituting lower limit u square by 2. So, it is AS is equal to V square minus U square by 2. So, which can be written as V square minus U square is equal to 2 AS, or you can write it as V square is equal to U square plus 2 AS, which is giving you the velocity displacement relation. Now, we know v is equal to u plus at. This is the first equation we derived. So, we can write this as at is equal to v minus u. Okay. And the second equation we derived is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay. Now, I am going to substitute instead of at v minus u. So, it is ut plus half for 1 AT, that is V minus U, into T. Okay. So, this can be written as UT plus half VT minus half UT. So, this you get it as UT minus half UT is half UT plus half AT. So S is equal to 1 by 2 T into U plus V. Or you can write it as S is equal to V plus U plus V into T by 2. So this is another relation we are getting from the above equations. So these four equations, that is S is equal to V is equal to U plus AT, S is equal to UT plus half AT square, V square is equal to U square plus 2AS, and S is equal to U plus V by 2 into T. These four equations we call it as kinematic equations.